वंदे गुरुपद्वंदम भक्तबिंदसमन्वितम् श्रीचैतन्य प्रभु वंदे नित्यानंदसहोदितम् श्रीनंदनंदन वंदे राधिका चरणोदयम् गोपीजनो समायुक्तम् बिंदावनम् मनोहरम् वांछाकल्पतरुवश्च कृपा सिन्धुभ्यः च पतितानं पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः मूकं करोति वाचालं पंगुं लंघयति गिरिं यत्कृपा तमहं वन्दे परमानन्दमाधवं वृन्दावै तुलसीदेव वै पियावै केशवस्य च कृष्णभक्तिपदे देवी सत्त्वत्वयि नमो नमः नारायण नमस्कृत नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयो मुदीरयः संकीर्तने कृष्ण कथोपदेशे गौरीयपत्रस्य प्रकाशने च सदानुरक्त गुरुभक्तियुक्तो भक्ति प्रमोदाख जगोद्वरुन धैयम् सदा परिभवग्नम अभिष्टदोहम् तीर्थास्पदम् शिव विरंचनुतम् शरण्यम् भीतातिहम् पुनतोपाल भवाद्दीपूतम् वंदे महापुरुषते चरणारविन्दम् यत्पादपल्लवनखचन्दमनि छटाया विस्फुरीजित किमपि गोपवधू स्वदर्श पूर्णानुराग रस सागर सार मूर्ति साराधिका मयि कदा कृपां करोषि श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवसदि गौर भक्तवृंद श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवसदि गौर भक्तबिंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे आजानुलंबित भुजौ कनकावतातु संकेतनैकपितरो कमलायताक्षो विश्वाम्बरो द्विजवरो जुगधर्मपालो वंदे जगत्प्रियकरो करुणावतारो हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे नमामि गंगे तव पाद पंकजं सुरासुरैर्वंदितो दिव्यरूपम् भुक्तिं च मुक्तिं च ददासि नित्यं भावानुरूपेण सदा नरानं गंगातरंगरमणीयजटाकलापं गौरीनिरन्तरविभूषितवामभागं नारायणो प्रियमनंगमदापहारम् वाराणसीपुरपति भजवीशनाथम वागीशजुष्व वदने लक्ष्मीर्जस्व च वक्षसि जस्यास्ति हृदय संवित्वं नृसिंहमहं भजे हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे निखिल भुवन माया छिन्न विच्छिन्न करती विबोध बहुल विज्ञान मुक्ति महां तदात्री शिथिलितो विधिरागाराध्य राधेश धानी बिलसतु हृदय नित्यम भक्ति सिद्धांत बानी बिलसतु हृदय नित्यम भक्ति सिद्धांत बानी। गौड़ीय गोष्ठीपति शिशिर भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद टोल्ड दैट टू ट्राई टू गेट एंट्री इनटू अप्राकृत डाइवर्सिटी विथ मेटेरियल कंसेप्शन इज क्वाइट इम्पॉसिबल। टू ट्राई टू गेट एंट्री इनटू अप्राकृत वैचित्र डाइवर्सिटी विथ मेटेरियल कंसेप्शन दिस इज क्वाइट इम्पॉसिबल। दिस कैन ओनली प्रूव लैक ऑफ डिस्क्रिशन देर इज नो ब्रेन एट ऑल। अप्राकृत विचार कैन नॉट डू। एक्चुअली मेनी टाइम आई टोल्ड बिफोर बिफोर स्टार्टिंग भजन एक्चुअली वील हैव टू सबमिट अन टू द लोटस फीट ऑफ गुरु वैष्णव। मेनी टाइम आई टोल्ड दिस इज द बेसिक की थिंग। एक्चुअली विदाउट सबमिशन अन टू द लोटस फीट ऑफ गुरुपाद पद्म आई कैन नॉट इवन स्टार्ट हरि भजन। वट टू स्पीक अबाउट अप्राकृत विचार आई कैन नॉट स्टार्ट हरि भजन। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई विल हैव टू गेट कंट्रोल ओवर माई माइंड। इन भागवतम इट इज रिटन सर्व एव मनो निग्रह लक्षणांता सर्व एव मनो निग्रह लक्षणांता। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई विल हैव टू गेट कंट्रोल ओवर माई माइंड विच इज नेक्स्ट टू इम्पॉसिबल बट स्टिल इट इज पॉसिबल बिकॉज बाई सबमिशन इट इज पॉसिबल फॉर मी टू सो एवरीथिंग। देन एक्चुअली लैक ऑफ फेथ इन गुरु वैष्णव और लैक ऑफ फेथ इन शास्त्र सिद्धांत विचार कैन नॉट अलाउ मी टू स्टार्ट हरि भजन। दैट इज द बिग प्रॉब्लम। स्लाइट डिस्ट्रस्ट इन गुरु वैष्णव एंड देयर सिद्धांत कैन पुट मी इन ग्रेट ट्रबल। संशयात्मा विनस्पति मेन थिंग एक्चुअली। सो अंटिल एंड अनलेस वी कैन स्टैंड ऑन आ एब्सोल्यूट प्लेटफॉर्म कॉमन प्लेटफॉर्म वी कैन नॉट एक्सेप्ट डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ विचार सिद्धांत विच वी कैन फाइंड इन आवर स्पिरिचुअल इन आवर गौड़ीय सिद्धांत इज इम्पॉसिबल टू एक्सेप्ट because body conception always I am busy with my body and material mind. This cannot allow me to stand on neutral platform to understand daiva varnasam issue. That is the main problem. This cannot allow to understand. It's not possible because I am busy with my material mind and body. Bonded soul always try to search own facility, personal facility. They are less interested about what going to happen. So we hear one thing, that everybody's property is nobody's property. So the spiritual property is open to all. So we think it is not our property. It is open to all. Jai bhaje sei boro. Who is going to do bhajan, he can come out successful. Who is not going to do bhajan, asa sangha doing. Because the key to hari bhajan is to avoid asa sangha. Asa sangha tyagi vaishnava achar. If you can think analytically, you can understand that you are already out of asa sangha or not. Some or other way, directly or indirectly, you are always doing some asasanga. That is the reason for why you cannot understand aprakita siddhanta vichar. Impossible. I already told, I can give the meaning of this sloka very shortly. Nikhilo bhubano maya chinna vichinna kriti korti. The vichar, I mean any kind of vichar given by Prabhupada, exclusive, is one kind of evolution. You cannot understand, not you, what to speak about you, big, big spiritual leader. They cannot accept. How it is possible? They cannot understand. So, before starting argument, I think we will have to hear very analytically why I am speaking all this thing. I have no personal interest, nothing. This has all along been my honest effort to guide you all perfectly without any smell of personal interest, pratishtha. That's why I can discuss this kind of points. Otherwise it is impossible. This has all along been my honest effort to guide you all perfectly without any smell of personal interest or pratishtha. Please don't try to take this issue on political platform. It is my request unto your lotus feet. Perhaps you ignore my Harikatha. I have given all answer. Still this kind of different kind of question coming to me. It is not at all critical question for me. You can put any question. I can give answer by the power of Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Gurudev. That's not a problem. But after going through this kind of question, I can realize that actually whether you have heard here Harikatha or not, I don't know. So, many times I told, Varnanam Visheso Nasti. Varnanam Visheso Nasti. There is no such as such so importance of this Varna. But still it is important so long as we are in bonded stage. So many doubts coming to put me in trouble in the ocean of misery. Varnanam Visheso Nasti, this I told many times. Because any man can beget body baby in any woman's womb. I told you, Yudhishthira Maharaj giving answer to Nahusraja. Nahusraja asking, how we can understand what is possible? Yudhishthira Maharaj speaking that as such there is no such speciality. Not possible. Because any man can beget baby in any woman's womb. In the womb of any woman. Any part of the world you are staying, any part of the world, maybe in different country, it's possible. But how we can understand who is Brahman and who is not? That is main issue, very sensitive issue. Because every possibility is there, you can misunderstand me. I have no particular, I have no personal interest, nothing. But standing on neutral platform, I am bound to speak that way. So, only I am going to discuss so that you can understand. If after hearing Harikatha, you are not going to grow humble attitude, then surely you are not hearing Harikatha. Hearing Harikatha means satsanga. And satsanga means I am going to cut my material bondage. And if material bondage is already cut, then I can realize what is what. So like one building is there, poor old building. Maybe it is one Jamindar house. Maybe for 500 years it's abandoned. But somehow from government, archaeology department, some full trim coming with big, big light, search light. Now point is that it is dark, full of darkness. But as soon as those people entering with light, they can see what is what. Similarly, when my diksha is perfect, my submission is perfect, then automatically, actually, I can get the kippa of Gurudev to realize everything. By my personal effort and argument, I cannot understand, I can understand nothing. It is not possible. It is not possible. So, diksha kale, shishya kare, atma samarpan, this kind of show. Also, from Switzerland and different place, some devotee putting such question. I am just surprised to see this kind of question. But surely I can give answer. But it will take one or two harikatha. So I can give answer. How we can understand Gauranga Mahaprabhu is aprakita? How we can understand all the parsad of Gauranga Mahaprabhu aprakita? This kind of question coming into the heart of that devotee, some devotee. So I can give answer. It will take one or two or three harikatha. Maybe I will have to give in details. Now, actually, it is our problem, really so. At present, society is so breakdown. In this situation, it is next to impossible to understand who is Brahman, who is Brahman and who is not. It is impossible. A prakita Brahmanatta who is having. But still, there is some procedure. And all the time, without argument, we have one instruction in Shastra, in Gita. Tasma Shastra Pramanante Kajya Kajyo Vyavasthita. What to do, what not to do, all we will have to take decision on the basis of Shastra. Now, if some Gurudev going to speak all rubbish against you, in that case, you say, my Gurudev speaking, I will have to accept, then what to speak? Because I cannot speak, I can speak only Harikatha, then you will have to take decision. Because Gurudev can never speak which is not supported in Shastra. Gurudev always speaking according to Shastra. Or at all sometimes speaking, maybe for testing me, to test me, it can be so. So, Guru Ropi Avalitapso Karja Karjo Majanato Utpata Patipanaso Paristago Vidhiyate. Then Pitama Vishwa speaking, he who is not going to understand what is good, what is not good, what is as per Shastra, what is not written in Shastra, is only speaking according to his whimsical attitude. In that case, that Guru we cannot accept. Even in Haribhakti Vilas also it is written, and Jiva Goswami Pada also in some place writing. I already told that Pitama Vishya going to reject his Gurudev because he is going to give instruction whimsically. So this kind of things we find. So first of all, actually, we will have to think that if Guru Kippa is there, only through Guru Kippa, be careful, only through Guru Kippa he can digest all Shastra Siddhanta. Be careful, this point. Even in Haribhakti Vilas and also Jiva Goswami Pada giving argument, that if Gurudev not going to cut your sansai, is different kind of doubts coming inside your heart. Sangsayatma Vinaspati. If different kind of contradictory points coming inside your heart, how is possible? How is that possible? This kind of doubts when coming, only Gurudev, Sadguru Vaishnava can cut these doubts. So they are Sadguru. Not then I can memorize all Shastra and can speak in front of you and get some clapping. Not that. Realization is a must. Now, this is your doubt. I can give answer. Whatever you wanted to know, all different question you already wanted to put in front of me, I am going to answer very carefully. So now, actually, Mahabharata you can go, Bhagavat Ji Mahapuran you can go, Chaitanya Charitamrita you can go. All the time you can get same Siddhanta. you are less interested to hear this point. Only you would like to go back your body from which country and which yellow color you are busy with this. So you are having some pretty have some negative conception. So Hari Bhajane Nahi Jatkula Di Vichar Jai Haja Sei Bharo Abhakta Hinchar Vaishnaver Jatikul Nirarthak Bujhaite Janmailen Haridase Jaban Kulete. Actually, it is written in Chaitanya Bhagavat also that for Vaishnava there is no caste and creed, you cannot, you know, you should not have any kind of conception. And Varnasam Dharma is almost useless, but for bonded soul is useful. To prove it, Haridas Thakur coming in Muslim family, just to prove that in Hari Bhajan it is not so important to prove it. So now actually in Mahabharat Shallo Parvo there is, you know, some question. Uma Devi putting question in front of Mahadev, Har Har Mahadev. In front of Mahadev Vaishnavanam Jathasambhu, Uma Devi wife Shakti going to put question. Mahadev is speaking, how is this possible? How it is possible? Etat me sansayam devo bato bodo bhuto pater anagha trayo varnaha prakati. Prakityevo katham brahmanyam apnuyu. Etatme sansayam, it is my doubt. Bado devo, he dev, you speak out please. Bhuta patir anagha, he nispap, you know, you are pure, you are. Etatme sansayam devo bado, bado when you speak out, I have some doubt. That trayo varnaha, atat khatriyo, vaisho, and Shudra, how they become Brahman? How it is possible for them to become Brahman? Because in Shastra, it is seen. Because Shastra, we can see this some so many such cases that they become Brahman. Vasishtha Muni took birth from the womb of Urvashi. You know, in heaven they are pros in Urvashi. This way, Vyasadeva took in Kaivartakul, Vyasadeva, Vaivhandaka Muni, all Rishasinga Muni from deer, Dronacharya from the pot in which we put arrow, Agastya Muni from, you know, from pitcher. You know, this way, different kind of question coming. And they already, we see, they are attaining such a, you know, top grade. All the time they are advising, they are giving advice all the time. Now, Shankar Bhagavan speaking, yes, it is possible. Kshatriya, Vaishya or Brahman, if their heart according to past sanskar, it is positive. Positive means they are favorable. They believe Supreme Lord, they like, you know. This way, if they are at all interested to follow Brahman Achar, please try to understand this point first, that Brahman is not body, so that you can speak, I am from this country, you are from this. No, Brahman is not body. Brahman is not color. Brahman is not, you know, family hereditary factor, not that. Brahman means who is having clear idea about Brahma, about Brahma, I mean who is at all interested to know Brahma Tattva, is going to follow all rules and regulation usually. It's an automatic factor. It's an automatic factor that they can follow Brahman rules. I already told 81 sons of Kshatriya Raj, you know, Rishabji, they become very pure Brahman. They become Brahman. Also, actually, that our that Muni, what name? Vishwamitra Muni, Vishwamitra Muni giving order to the to his sons, all sons, you will have to follow Sunasev as the elder brother. Some of them going to obey, and some of them not going to obey him. Then Vishwamitra Muni curse them, throw them, that go away. Yeah, I am not going to give any place. I have no place for you all. They all become mlecho. This way in Shastra we see different kind of, you know, examples are there. Now, Shankar Bhagavan speaking, it matters little in which family he has taken birth. Maybe Kshatriya, Vaishya, if they are going to follow Brahman Achar, they are going to adopt total Brahman Acharan, everything. So many things you can find in, if you go through Shastra without guidance, you can be in an ocean of anxiety, in the ocean of doubts. So please don't do that. Any Shastra, maybe Sandarbha, this, that, if you read personally, you can develop doubts after doubts. You can kill him yourself. Be careful. I already told 1 year, 2 years back that some, you know, people, they are thinking we are Pandit. We can read all books. After reading all books, Goswami books, they come out with this conception, Siddhanta, that Jiva Goswami path not going to follow at all Sanatana Rupa. Now come, what to speak? After reading for years, they're reading so many books, they have their capacity of brain. After that, they come out with this conclusion that Jiva Goswami path not at all going to follow Sanatana Rupa. Then what we can say? Jiva Goswami path is not in favor of Parakya, that they want to prove. So this way, if you like to go through Shastra, is dangerous. You cannot understand. I don't know who is your guru, how you are initiated. All different issues are there. Standing on neutral platform, I am going to speak. I am not going to criticize anybody. So body is not Brahman. Your material mind is not Brahman, nothing. Only your sadachar, sanskar, pure heart, can prove that you are Brahman. That is why I told that day, Mahaprabhu speaking in front of the son-in-law of Sarvamataja Joe, Amogh, that why you are going to invite on a Master Chandal? Master Jachan, why you are going to invite? It is quite natural, the heart of, you know, Brahman is pure. Sahaje nirmal ei Brahman hidoy, Master Chandal kene iha basaila, pavitra stan kene apavitra kaila. If there is politics, if there is dirty politics, if there is always, always suffering from, from demand. I should get this, you are not getting honor, this. This is called shok. Shok. Always busy, collect money, this, that, business, all. Bhajan is also one kind of business for them. So how we can say they are Brahman? If Brahman, then heart must be clear. So you see, it's quite natural that the heart of a Brahman is clean. There is no complicacy, no politics, nothing. If such, you know, problems are there, different problems, be sure. And how we can know that you are Shudra? How you can know that I am Shudra? How you can know? Maybe I am doing some acting in front of you. But be careful. If I am going to do acting, 1 day, 2 day, 3 day, 5 day, 7 day I can do. But after some time, the screen can get over, you can discover my dirty heart. There is no respite. So if there is some dissatisfaction all the time, demands, it's called Shudra. Shokam karoti iti Shudra. who is always repenting, ah, oh, I am not getting this, I am not getting this, this, you know, all the time. So they are actually Shudra. So to understand who is Brahman, who is Shudra, Sadguru Vaishnava, they have their X-ray eyes. Their eyes is so clean. They can look at you, they can understand what is there inside your heart. So they can, also you can remember Sudama Vipro and Krishna when discussing with each other, when Sudama Vipro went to Dwaraka. In that case, Sudama Vipro, in front of Sudama Vipro, Krishna asking, perhaps you already marry a matching, you know, meaning couple should be matching. There should be, I can go for medical term also, genetical factor, all I can discuss. So that you have no scope to fight with me. Be careful. You will have to hear it very carefully. Sadrisho Nova. Perhaps you are already married and your wife must be matching with you. What do you mean by matching? In Vedic mantra, Rig Veda, there is a marriage. If marriage is done according to Vedic culture, it is a system here. That whenever you are going to, you know, take the responsibility of wife, then you will have to speak one mantra. Jadidam hidayam tavo tadidam hidayam mamo. From today onward, your heart in and my heart is totally matching. There cannot be any disparity. There should not be any disparity. Actually, marriage means unification of two hearts having to two different X. So marriage means actually because negative potency and positive potency, they get balance. So in chemistry we do neutralization, acid base. So why marriage is necessary? Why marriage is not necessary for brahmacharis, sannyasi, if they are at all going to follow it? If they are going to show that we are sannyasi, then kapat, what is the solution? This is the situation of this whole world. So I cannot fight with people. I can speak this way. If you have your, you know, saranagati, you can accept it. Marriage according to a conception is one kind of enjoyment. But according to Vedic culture, there is no such issue. There is no such, you know, case. So marriage is only mean, you know, to, I can also speak sloka also. Nice, sundar, very good, you can understand. So first point you understand that Mahadev Shankar Bhagavan speaking, if those, you know, Kshatriya, Vaishya, they are at all going to follow rules and regulation properly, in that case, if they are going to follow Brahmanism, Brahman rule, in that case, no problem. They can be accepted as Brahman, Sabhav. Also, in Rai Ramananda Sangbad, I published actually 12 years back, maybe more. If I can translate it into English, it is the lecture of Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati, at the bank of Godavari, where the spot where actually Rai Ramananda and Mahaprabhu's discussion took place. Their first argument, Mahaprabhu wanted to hear Sadhya Sadhan Takta, how to go ahead. Then the first argument was given by Rai Mahasai in front of Mahaprabhu, that Prabhu said, what do you think good, how people can do bhajan, what is the... Then from the beginning, actually Rai Ramananda speak, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare. Actually, at the bank of Godavari, at the bank of Godavari, Mahaprabhu discussing with Rai Ramananda, Rai Mahaswai, you can speak about Bhajan Tattva. Then first of all, Rai Mahaswai started speaking, Varnasrama Dharma Palon Bhagavat Seva Antargata Vishwai. Mean, Varnasrama Dharma is one part of, is one kind of Bhagavat Seva. You know, it is also, through Varnasrama Dharma, it is possible to do Bhagavat Seva, So, it is possible. But that Varnasrama Dharma, if you at all understand, then you can do. If you are not going to understand what is Varnasrama Dharma, you are going to think all rubbish, how you can serve? So, in here, it is also possible, through Varnasrama Dharma, it is also possible to serve Supreme Lord. So Rai Mahaswa speaking from Vishnu Puran, Varnasrama Charavata Purusheno Parahapamano Vishnu Raradhati Pantha Nanatatosho Karanam. Varnasrama Charavata Purusheno Parahapaman Vishnu Raradhati Pantha Nanatatosho Karanam. So this sloka, if I explain, you can understand. It means, through Varnasrama Dharma, it is possible to serve Supreme Lord. It is also possible. So, it is one kind of procedure. So, when Bhagavan Sri Krishna discussing with Sudama Vipra, they are also asking, maybe you have accepted matching wife in your life. Matching means actually, Varnam and Astro and Jaitya should be matching. If we are at all going to break the system, who is going to arrest you? We have nothing to do. You are at liberty to do anything you like. But if you at all believe in this Shastra Vakya, if we all can follow this system, then somehow we can get some unique result. You see? So, Brahman is not body, Brahman is not color, Brahman is not, you know, material mind, nothing. So, this way actually we can prove that Brahman is actually heart, plain heart, pure heart, where there is no complicacy, nothing, no duplicity, nothing. Saral mean, pure heart mean, there should not be any complicacy. Plain-hearted. But sometimes we point out some foolish person, we can say, Maharaj, he is actually saral. Not that. Saralata is totally different thing and foolishness is totally different thing. Merit is totally different thing and devotion is totally different thing. So we sometimes make confusion. We say, actually genius, Maharaj is very genius. So what? There can be so many genius in the society, but they are not all going to do bhajan. So genius actually, I mean merit can be there. And Hari Bhajan is a function of heart, not material mind, nothing. So actually, lack of faith in Guru Vaishnava or lack of faith in Shastra Vakya Vichar cannot allow me to start Hari Bhajan at all. This is the main problem. False ego can, you know, ruin me, my spiritual life, big problem. So at all, if I have any honest inquiry, then I can put question, then I can get solution. So Sadguru, Sadvaishnava, Sadguru must give solution to any problem you are facing, actually. So, you see, actually, if there is doubt and contradiction, Jiva Goswami Pad speaking, that if I am not going to give any solution from my Gurudev for any problem, then big problem. Then in today or tomorrow you can grow some doubts, you can stop bhajan, you can express doubt about Gurudev, he cannot answer me. This way there is big problem. So, So in Shastra it is written, Shabde Parecha Nishnatam Brahmani Upasamasrayam. Shabde Parecha Nishnatam, Sabda Brahma means all authentic scripture, all the gist of Shastra, he must realize by the mercy of his Gurudev. Shabde Parecha Nishnatam means Nishnatam means totally verse. In Sabda Brahma and Parabrahma, Parabrahma means direct realization of bhajan. What I can expect from Gurudev? I can expect, what I can expect from, not that Gurudev can give me money, some position, glamour, not that. Gurudev can give me direct realization of his bhajan, what he is doing all the time. So, all the time Gurudev doing bhajan, that is his identity. All the time, 24 hours, aprakita bhajan, he is engaged. And he is going to give his direct realization of seva inside my heart. In that case, I can also, if I am inclined, then I can also get inspiration to do seva properly. I can also. Many times I told that varnasam dharma is, you know, scientific procedure, daiva varnasam, scientific procedure. If we can apply it in our social life, gradually we can find positive result, very good result. But it is now impossible. Still in our bhajan field we can also try. At least in our, you know, bhajan field we can try to apply. If everybody going to break this system, then what to do? Nothing to know. Who is going to arrest you? Nobody is there. So actually, many times I told you, Vasudev Goswami took birth in fisherman family. So this way, different kind of, you know, I already, Vasishtha Muni took birth from Urvashi, but they all attain, they actually show us their quality. So this way, it is possible. But that doesn't mean I can make some disturbance in the society. So Prabhupada wanted to give this system to me. Now I want to explain some points what Prabhupada wanted to show. Prabhupada one day, long ago, when Prabhupada was there one day in Calcutta Gauriya Mission there, then one big freedom fighter, not only freedom fighter, he has great faith in Guru Vaishnava and Bhagavan. And his mother used to hear Harikatha from Prabhupada. His name is Netaji Subhas Chandra Bose. Subhas Bose was a great personality in material world. And you know, ICS that time, big personality, very intelligent. And he had faith in Shastra, everything. His mother used to hear Harikatha from Prabhupada in Gauriya Mission. So one day he wanted to meet Prabhupada before, yeah, because he is already involved in, you know, freedom fighting. One day he entered, I heard it from Gurudev directly, Guruma told me. One day Subhas was coming and gate, I was there. So he asking, you want to meet with Prabhupada? So I told, I must ask pass the permission. Then I speak to Prabhupada, Prabhupada, somebody coming, whose name? Subhas was he like to meet you, take some kripa from you. Well, you can allow him to come there, because that time is seva time, all the time. Not always anybody can, only Parampuja Sridhar Goswami Maharaj, Ramananda Vohiya, when he was in Purvasram, previous ashram, he used to come. No time, maybe in the noon time, but still, Prabhupada always, you know, speaking, he is allowed, any time he is coming. You must allow him to come to me, a special permission. So Subhas was coming and now discussion going on. Prabhupada speaking some Harikatha, he is listening very carefully, with full attention. After that, Prabhupada asking, what is your target in your life? He is speaking, my target is to make my motherland free from bondage. You know, because liberty, I like to get liberty for my countrymen. So then Prabhupada speaking, so you are going to fight with British people, huh? British, yes, yes. Then Prabhupada asking, you already told that you are reading Gita. Yes, I am reading Gita. You are always reading Gita in your life, all the time. He is reading Gita. Even when we was making Azadin Forge, that time he was also reading Gita 3 times in a day. Well, now if you are reading Gita, please give me answer. That is written there that Basangsi Jiranani Yatha Bihayo Navani Grinati Naro Aparani. You believe that man can die, his Jivatma can go to enter into another body? Yes, I believe, Janmantar. But then I am putting one question in front of you. Now you are going to fight with British people. You would like to make India free. It's very good because you have commitment in front of countrymen. But suppose next life you are going to take birth in Great Britain, you can just fight with India. He was just stunned. Really so? But what to do? I cannot come back because I have standing commitment in front of countrymen. So he could realize this point. So it is all apparent. It's all apparent. This life he is taking birth in India. Next life he is going to take birth in Great Britain. Still next birth he is going to take birth in Africa, forest. Who can speak? Who can say? So this is all apparent actually. But still, if somebody is going to enter into Hari Bhajan perfectly as going to do bhajan, then he can attain at least Brahmanism in heart first. Then he can go ahead and sit into the asana of, you know, Vaishnava. So Vaishnava asana is topmost designation. Topmost designation is Brahmanism. Many times I told, even Chandal, you know, all the example, you know, Guhak Chandal going to get the kipa of Ramchandra. Sabari Mata going to get kipa. Tribal is going to get kipa of Ramchandra. Gurudev first, Gautam Muni. So also in Bhagavatam we have so many documents, countless documents. We know from Kapil Dev speaking to Devahuti Ma. Devahuti Ma speaking, after hearing so many Harikatha, Siddhanta, then Devahuti Ma speaking, that actually any caste, irrespective of caste and creed, is going to do Hari Bhajan, he become topmost, you know, purity can attain. Jannama dheya savanana kirtanat jat prahavanat jat smaranat api kachit sado yopi sadda savanaya kalpati kutaha punaste bhagavannu darshanat aho vato sapachato opi gariyan jat jiu bhagri vartat namato bhyam te pustapaste juhubu susnurarya Brahmyanu Uchuranamo Grinanti Jeti. So Jannamo Dhyo Savananu Kirtanad Jat Prahavanad Jat Smaranadupi Kachit Shadu Opi Shaddu Savanayu Kalpati Kutaha Punaste Bhagavannu Darshan. What to speak about your Darshan, Prabhu? When somebody is going to take your name, he can attend, thinking about you, speaking your thing, you know, Savananu Kirtana, Jannamo Dhyo Savananu Kirtanat, you know. So this way, they can attain highest perfection. Aho Bato, then speaking Aho Bato, what to speak? Sapacho, those who are previously they used to cook the flesh of, you know, meat of, you know, dog. Aho Bato Sapachato Pigoriyan, even Chandal, all they become so pure, that they are just fit to sit for yagya, any yagya. Nam yagya is topmost. So, jannama dheya savanana kirtanat jat prahavanat jat smaranat api kachit shado yupi saddha savanayakalpati kutaha punaste bhagavannu darshanat aho vato sapachato opikariyan jat jivu bhagri varatate namato vyam ते पुस्तपस्ते जुहुवु सुष्णुधार्या ब्रह्म्यानु चोरनाम गृणन्ति येते. सो ऑल दोस डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ श्लोकास कैन प्रूव इट मैटर्स लिटल. इट मैटर्स लिटल दैट इन व्हाट यू नो कंट्री यू आर, व्हाट कंट्री, व्हाट कलर, व्हिच यू नो कास्ट. सो वर्णाश्रम धर्म वॉज एप्लीकेबल इन इंडिया ऑल अलोंग. If there was no varnasam, was still okay in different countries. Still, if they do Hari Bhajan, they can do Hari Bhajan, but they cannot make any disturbance. According to the instruction of Krishna, they cannot make any disturbance in society. If they at all going to make any disturbance, a big problem. So, Sankaraha Narakaya Ibakalpa. Sankara Narakaya Ibakula Gnanam Kula Sacha. Shankar, a Shankar, I mean hybrid, is going to make big problem in the society. Now, if you have at all any doubt inside your heart still today, if I ask you to marry one tribal man in a forest, you are ready to marry? You are ready or not? If not, why not? If not, you are not ready, why not? That is my question. I can speak one joke, very nice, I heard when I was student. There was a big scientist, you know, Negro scientist. Negro, you know, is originally is from Africa, you know, but he is American scientist maybe, I forget. Big scientist. He is so intelligent that what to speak. Big scientist. One day he was sitting in a park. One beautiful lady, approaching that scientist, and with humble mood speaking, "I know your name, I know your fame. Now I have one request. If you can marry me, is very good, because in that case, if we can get one child, baby, who is just intelligent like you and just looking like me, is so nice that case." Then that scientist laughing and speaking, "I am just thinking opposite. He is just you know, no brain like you and just looking like me. In that case, what will happen?" So, varnasram dharma, why we are going to follow, we will have to go deep into this matter. So, it's good actually. So, in that case, I was speaking about Netaji Subhas Bose. Then Netaji Subhas Bose could realize this point, that is all apparent. In which country I am going to take birth, which place, which caste, all, you know. Because after death, your identity, this kind of apparent identity, not going to stay. But permanent identity, your permanent identity, that you are the servant of Krishna, is your permanent identity. You will have to maintain this identity, permanent identity. So also, you know, the social structure, to maintain the social structure very, you know, appropriate way. So this is a must. This is a must. We'll have to follow this system. Otherwise, all, you know, all big problem can take place. And actually, people can run fancifully. So it is not your conception is not good, that I have some, you know, some party color, not that. Actually, those who are foreign devotees, actually they are going to get maximum, you know, kripa. They are all those foreign and my foreign childrens. They are all my foreign children. They are foreign devotees of my foreign children. They are going to get maximum love. I am sitting in Vyasasan. I speak you. They feel always from heart that I am always with them inside your room. So, all my foreign devotees, they are all my foreign children. They are going to get maximum love. Maximum love. Unalloyed love. So for them I reserve. So for them I reserve all spiritual, my spiritual property for them. So, if they are at all interested, they can accept. But if this is no very simple issue, if they are going to express doubt, this, that, then how I can, you know. So, this way, so this all external varnasam dharma, actually all external, but still you will have to follow. Otherwise, big disturbance can be there. At least whole world not going to follow. At least you are, you know, you are coming in Hari Bhajan, you should follow it. So, actually, point is there. So, according to your previous karma fall, according to your previous karma fall, you will have to take birth. In which country, which place, in which family you can take birth, it depends. According to your previous karma fall. If your previous karma fall is okay, then you are going to take birth in a nice family. Be careful. If you want to express doubt about this also, I can guide you. You can go to Gita. You can go to Gita and search. There also, Arjuna going to put question in front of Krishna. If somebody is going to start one yoga, yoga means karma yoga, dhyan yoga, gyan yoga, rajguha yoga, specially bhakti yoga. Yes, there is, you know, special facility. So, Arjuna going to speak, suppose somebody doing bhajan. If somebody going to do bhajan, and after that, if he is not going to come out successful, then what to do? If he is not at all coming out successful in this life, then he can be finished. What will happen? Krishna said, no. If anybody going to do some yoga, yoga means gyan yoga, dhyan yoga, rajguha yoga, bhakti yoga, in that case, he is not going to die because a spirit, atma, is going to get support, bal, power. Partho naiveha namutro binasastasyo vidyate. He cannot go down and down. Maybe he finished. He couldn't come out successful in a midway breakdown, but still he can get facility. According to his grade of increment, in what stage he was there before leaving his body, it depends. His yoga was, if he is okay, not so bad. So in that case, partho naiveha, partho na eva iha, not this in this material world, na mutro, after death, when he was living in this earth, in that case there was no problem as such. You know, and after death, surely he is not going to meet with problem, great problem. He cannot get lost. So, it is an automatic factor. So, partho naiveha namutra vinasastasya vidyate nahi kalyano krit kaschit durgatim tato gachati. Who is already started yoga in his life. I mean, yoga means to get in connection with Krishna, Supreme Lord, or Ram. Anyway, he is not at all going to get lost. He can get some facility next life. So, Krishna speaking, prappaho punna kritam lokanu ushitva saswati samaha suchi nam srimatam gehe yoga bharsto abhijayate. Prappo, then maybe according to his activities, doing some yoga, but with some, maybe some pious activities may be there also. So he cannot come out successful, but prappo panna kritam lokam. He can be given a highest, you know, planet. After that, staying there for a long time, he can again come back to take birth in a very nice family, to get success again. And whenever he is going to get, take birth in a family, in that case, he can discover that family is, you know, favorable family. I know so many cases, those girl and boys, from their birth, they are not take any, they are not going to take any non-veg. I know them. I love them very much. Because mother and father following these rules, so according to that, they are going to, you know, get same habit. They are not feeling any trouble. So they are going to get the scope to take birth in such a family. Favorable condition can be there. And the place, breakdown, the place where he meet with breakdown, from then he can remember and again start bhajan. Athoba yoginam eva kule, athoba yoginam eva kule bhavati dhimatam etad hi durlabataram loke janmo. You know, is this kind of birth is rare. So now, by now you understand, to take birth in a nice family, to take birth in a nice country, it is not a matter of fighting. It depends upon your previous activities. So you can have some false ego. Oh, Maharaj going to hate us. No, who told? Who told? You know, you actually, I mean, you misunderstand actually. So, this way we can prove 100% that Varnasam Dharma is very effective, we can follow. And according to nature, according to their nature, they can start showing their activities. So, those who are elevated sadhu, they can detect that they have some, their you know, mood, their bhava is very suitable, like Brahman. So this way they have their right to do Hari Bhajan. So why I am going to get busy with which country, color, this, that? You know, this Varnasam, Daiva Varnasam Dharma is not at all apartheid padhati. It is not at all prejudicial conception. Don't misunderstand. You should not think that way. It is one kind of prejudicial conception. Not. Scientific application I can show you. Scientific application. But first point is that we are not going to open Gauriya Math, we are not going to open Math to you know, make, you know, some hooligan. We are, you know, we need not make any Math anymore. It is the request of Prabhupada. Actually, at present we need not make any Math. We need to make mobile Math. If you have your capacity, maybe you have money, you can open a mart in England, here, there, France, Italy, anywhere. But if you have your power, you try to make mobile mart, mobile Gauriya Math. That the thing Prabhupada wanted to point out, to you know, to finish the problem from the root. But nobody going to hear. Prabhupada wanted to speak that if I can make, you are speaking about 50 Gauriya Maths. I wanted to establish Gauriya Math inside the heart of everybody. Whereas some acharya going to speak, don't go to Gauriya Math. Don't do this, that. So where Prabhupada speaking this way? Prabhupada speaking this way actually, that we want to make Gauriya Math inside the heart of everybody. Gauriya Math mean? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's teachings, everything. So, point is that if we are going to fight on this point, it's no use actually. We should understand the heart of Prabhupada. Prabhupada speaking, that I want to get 50 mobile Gauriya Maths. So those who are, you know, going to make open Maths, they can see the conditions of all Maths and Mandir, see the situation, who can get control. So it is good if they are going to make mobile Gauriya Maths, if they can, it is my request. Then in that case there is no problem. We are opening Math not to increase the number of beggar. We are not going to maintain Gauriya Math and mission to increase the number of beggar. They can go and beg and eat. They can lead their lazy life. So this is not good actually. So actually what Prabhupada wanted to speak, if they are going to follow Chaitanya Vani, then what to speak about Brahmanism? They can go topmost level of Krishna Prema. But nobody going to think about this point. They are busy with some simple points. simple points. So you think if this this man going to marry him and it's not allowed, okay, I can give you one example. I can give one by one example, you know, then I can come back to again what Prabhupada want to speak. On medical ground also, suppose you are born and brought up in such a country, there, you know, situation is totally different, your environment, climate totally different. You are going to marry a Negro man there, who is staying in a, you know, some African country, very hot. In that case, what can happen? In that case, what you can expect? So there is big problem can be there. Also, you know, genetical factors are there. Genetical factors, very important. So there is no matching of climate, nothing, environment, mind, nothing. If you can say, Maharaj, we are in love affair with each other, I can prove it is not at all love. It is one kind of karma. I can 100% prove that it is karma, not love. Love, this word is not applicable in this, you know, immaterial world. Though we are going to apply this word, love, this word is not at all applicable in transcendental world. Atma, it is applicable for Atma, spirit, not your body, not your body color, not your, you know, nothing, not your material mind. This love is such a pure term which is only applicable for Atma. So it's quite natural. Atma, one Atma can love another Atma. But your conception is, you know, so you are speaking, if somebody is actually Christian, husband, and wife is, you know, Muslim, then you can answer me. You will have to think what will happen. If they give birth to a boy, baby, what will happen? What is future? What future? You think about this point. You think what will happen. There is no way. Where can that boy go? If Christian father and mother is actually, you know, Muslim. If Muslim people coming to hear Harikatha, Satsanga, then there is no problem. Be careful. If Muslim people coming for Harikatha is very good, they can hear. That doesn't mean he is coming to Harikatha, we can allow him to enter into temple, hear, there, everything. Not that. A question of sanskar. Whereas we know, in our society, Vedic culture, janmana jayate sudro, sanskara dijo bhavet. Even if you are going to take birth in Brahmin family, still you are Shudra. Unless you are going to undergo sanskar. If sanskar is not there, sanskar is a big term. Sanskar means renovation. Sanskar is very fine term. In English there is, you know, I cannot find any suitable word. So, you see, he can come to hear Harikatha. After hearing Harikatha, you watch him. If he is going to change his life or not, you speaking, he is going to maintain his, Islamic Dharma, also coming to stay with. You have your power to digest that kind of contamination. I have no apartheid system idea, but you can digest. You are elevated up to that point. First of all, you will have to watch if he is coming to do satsanga, there is no problem. But after satsanga, some time, he is going to change his heart or not. If he is not at all going to change his heart, then be careful. I already answered many times before that if somebody coming in Gauriya Math for long, that day I was speaking, but he is not feeling it necessary to change his life, to take initiation from Sadguru, in that case, Jiva Goswami Pada also says, Rupa Goswami Pada, this is not at all satsanga. It is not at all satsanga. Satsanga is so important, so powerful, that it is going to give result 100%. Like, knowingly, unknowingly, if you are going to take poison going to show result in your body. So satsanga, knowingly or unknowingly you are doing, like I can give you example actually, you can know, when Mahaprabhu wanted to cross the river in Pichalda, one Muslim people came. That Muslim people, it was his responsibility to take one boat and help Mahaprabhu to cross the river. In that case, after crossing the river, when Mahaprabhu going away, then that Muslim people, he was so, you know, he was in love with Mahaprabhu. He just fell down, unconscious. This is called Sangha. This is called actually Sangha. This is called Sangha actually. That the dog of Sivananda Sen, is dog. He don't know how to do satsanga. But the Sivananda Sen, by the mercy of Sivananda, is giving Uchishta, Maha Mahaprasad, everything. Sivananda Sen guiding him up to Nilachal, wanted to guide. But in the meantime, the dog, I am not going to speak in details, the dog vanished, nobody can see. After that, when they reach Purushottam Dham, Nilachal Dham, when they reach, Gambhira Mandir, Sivananda Sen discovered that same dog, that the dog already reached here. And Mahaprabhu sitting in a rock and giving Mahaprasadam and a coconut. Take, Hare Krishna, you can speak this way. Mahaprabhu speaking. Mahaprabhu actually speaking. So this way, Mahaprabhu giving Harinam to that dog, and that dog vanished. So how it was possible for the dog to attain success? How it was possible for the dog to get success? That is the main thing. So you know, this way I can give example, knowingly or unknowingly he is going to get satsanga, he can change his heart. So if he is that Muslim boy, not going to change his heart, then we can say he is not actually doing satsanga. And also if you are going to mix freely, you know, you want to prove that you are elevated devotee, shortly you can get reaction of that. Because that day I was speaking, suppose you have cholera and some devotee have malaria, you both going to help each other, then you can get both two disease. One disease at present, you can develop both cholera and he can get also together with, you know, cholera, malaria. So this is not the procedure. So if he is at all going to change his heart, going to do satsanga, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare. I was speaking how it is possible for a dog also, you know, to get kripa. This way I can prove that if you are at all interested in Hari Bhajan, then there cannot be any problem. If you have some annavilas, different kind of, you know, desire, then you can put different kind of question. If some boy or girl going to, you know, they, by birth is going to take, is going to take birth in other country, other than India. So now question is that father and mother, they are originally from India, are they are already from Vedic culture or not? If at all, in that case by birth he can get, that country they can give, citizenship. Also is not going to make any disturbance, because first of all we'll have to think, maybe he take birth there, but still originally blood is there or not, his blood is there or not, or some problem is there. So this is very vital thing. So If there is climate and everything different, different kind of climate, different situation, then total adjustment is not possible. So marriage is not a matter of joke. As per Vedic culture, marriage means one done, done forever. Two soul unification. But outside marriage means maximum 1 year or 2 years. This is not actually marriage. This is not actually marriage. They don't know the meaning of marriage. They have no idea about what is called marriage, you know. So according to Varnasam Dharma, it's okay. You have to follow. Also, some medical problems can be there, medical terms. If somebody is going to ask you that if blood, if you need blood, suppose your health is very bad, you will have to take blood from outside market. Then there is no guarantee whose blood, which group may be okay. But if there is at all any germ or not, doctor can test, but still cannot come out successful. So when somebody is going to take blood transfusion, there can also be problem. Suppose one Vaishnava, he like to die, but still he is not going to take blood from outside. Taking blood from outside means contamination coming. Very at all right source, suppose in my life I already done, in Vrindavan some sadhu, operation was going to be done, the doctor speaking blood need. Then one brahmachari, Vaishnava, was ready. He's from Brahmin family originally. He ready to give blood, then that blood was given. Otherwise, blood contamination also can be there. There can be big problem in your life. I can show you one example. In Chakrodaha, Chakdaha, one place, just near Kishanagar. There one man is there, he's very nice. He is almost soft heart, he's not initiated, but he's going to hear Harikatha all the time, everything. One day he was very sick. So sick, then doctor going to prescribe that you will have to take blood. You have to test your blood and also you will have to take blood. He is going to take blood from a high class in West Bengal, that is topmost place. In Calcutta, there is topmost place, that pathological library. In whole India has some rank. From there he is going to take his blood and take blood. After taking blood, when he was in home, then doctor discover then HB germ already coming through. For whole life he is going to take medicine, thousands of rupees. That disease, there is no solution. Only through medicine, you can arrange their sleeping. Those germ can sleep in the blood. You cannot destroy HB germ. He is crying in front of me speaking, Maharaj, just I took blood from the high, from topmost place, so that there cannot be any contamination. But they say, through blood, I am giving to you. Then people can say, I am very rough character. So, actually, Haragobindo Khurana, that scientist, Nobel Prize owner, he also do some research on genetical. There, genetical factors is very important. Otherwise, if you marry fancifully, like mad, then those, children, boys, they will have to suffer. That is the result, you will have to. So, it's not a matter of fighting, you will have to understand this point. Not a matter of fighting, you see. So, actually, point is that, so in Varnasam Dharma, Daiva Varnasam Dharma, there is so scientific procedure, if you follow, then you are going to get result, very good result. Prabhupada in his life wanted to apply according to the order of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he wanted to show that it is possible. But unluckily, we are so foolish, we could not accept properly. Also, I am going to speak. Prabhupada wanted to do so many things. Not only the Daiva Varnasam, so many things Prabhupada wanted to do. Next day I can also discuss some point. Prabhupada wanted to make Vishnu Priya Palli to arrange bhajan from Matajis. Those Matajis, if they are at all going to live in Vishnu Priya Palli, they can do bhajan. Prabhupada wanted to arrange. But unluckily, Prabhupada makes some rules and regulation. Prabhupada makes some rules and regulation that in Vishnu Priya Palli, no brahmachari can go. Only one Ishan Thakur, one devotee, old devotee like Ishan Thakur can take control over that. But shortly, many problems took place. Then Prabhupada was speaking, oh my God, oh Krishna, I want to make this, you know, nice procedure so that they can do bhajan. But that is not possible. Because bonded soul, for them, wherever they stay, maybe in forest, maybe this country, that country, it matters little. Always problem. So sadhu sangha, through sadhu sangha is most important factor. So sadhu sangha, through sadhu sangha, they can change their heart, everything they can change. It's possible for them to change. Right, you know, I can give so many examples, it's possible. So, also those who are elevated devotees, those who are staying in mat to guide us properly, if we are going to think that they have no, you know, mercy, they're not going to do adjustment, milya mishya, they don't know how to adjust, so they are always finding fault with us, then surely I am not going to do bhajan. If I am at all interested to do bhajan, in that case, I must rely, believe that Vaishnava, what speaking, is all perfect. Basic belief. So, Goshti bhajan, you can get facility. Varnasam dharma, Daiva Varnasam, Guru Vaishnava can watch what is your nature, how, I was already that day speaking. If somebody in family life, he has strong attraction for family life, a strong attraction from money, woman, everything. Somebody going and doing preaching in false preaching and going to break all his, you know, system and going to say you can stay in our temple. Then all his young boy is not going to get education properly, not guidance properly. Wife is young, all gone, breakdown. So this is not the system I already told. You should not disturb. You should not, I can discuss that when Sutadev Goswami is speaking Harikatha, then Sanakadi is speaking that we know in Veda, except Veda, Sutadev Goswami, in front of Sutadev Goswami, Sanakadi is speaking, Tat sarvam na samachaksho pristo jadiho kinchano manne tvam visaye bacham snatam annatto chandasat. We know only in Veda you have no right, because he is not by birth Brahman, also, you know. So, it is written that we know that you are getting paramarthik brahmanatta. Paramarthik brahmanatta, everything, perfection, paramansa. But still, they should not disturb the social system. So, Sanakadir is speaking, you must speak all Harikatha so that you can, so that we can, you know, get benefits. So, tat sarvam na samajaksho, tat sarvam means everything you can speak. Harikatha, you know all Siddhanta Vichar, everything, because you already, you know, heard from Sukadev Goswami, Sukadev Goswami Gurudev. So, tat sarvam na samachaksho pristo jadiho kinchano manne tvam visaye vacham snatam annatto chandasat. Except Veda, you have right in all sastra, Mahabharata, actually Ramayana, or in Bhagavatam, everything. So, you can speak. So, according to our false ego, we can speak. Why? I cannot go through Veda. Arre, Maharaj, if you go through Veda, it's not allowed. So, we are busy with fighting. So, also that day I was speaking, स्त्री शूद्रो द्विजो बंधूनाम त्रयी न सूति गोचरहा स्त्री वुमेन शूद्र द्विजो बंधु यू नो सो मेनी ब्राह्मण आई कैन शो यू लाइक अजामिल अजामिल वॉज ब्राह्मण बट फॉल डाउन हार्ट ऑफ अजामिल वॉज वेरी गुड ही फॉल डाउन फ्रॉम हिज ओन पोजिशन बिकम शूद्र मोर देन शूद्र डाउन एंड डाउन ऑल्सो अश्वत्थामा यू नो he is from brahmin family but out of his jealousy all doing all rubbish he kill all five you know boys of panchapandav he become very heartless still today he is going to get punishment no solution krishna not going to excuse still today ashwatthama doing bhajan in Vrindavan. One place is there near Nandagram, Pisai Gaon. Still today, somebody can watch. Not always. He is doing bhajan to cut his, you know, this aparad. Because dham seva, he is doing dham seva, cleaning dham. Because Krishna not going to give kipa, Krishna not going to excuse. But dhamma, Baladev Tattva someday can excuse me. That's why Jagai Madhe also wanted to get seva from Gauranga Mahaprabhu. So they wanted to take seva that Jagai Madai got. They are cleaning the ghat. They are paying dandavat to Guru Vaishnava all the time. So this way they wanted to cut their previous Chaitanya Mahaprabhu give kiva already. You know this way. So stri shudro dijo bandhu nam dijo bandhu mean Ashwatthama is not at all Brahman. Dijo bandhu mean fallen. Totally fallen Brahman. So, stri shudra dijo bandhu nam trayi na suti gocharaha. Trayi mean they have no right to go through Veda Vedanta. So, karma sriyansi muranam sriya evam bhavediho. They have no right to sit for jagya also. So, this way, iti bharatam akhyanam kripaya manina kitam. This way actually Vyasadev Goswami thought it necessary to compile Mahabharat. And Mahabharat, Prabhupada speaking, you should not go through Mahabharat. You can be in confusion, you cannot understand, you cannot digest. But though Mahabharat, Ramayana is more, you know, Ramayana, Mahabharat is Jaya Grantho. But still there can be some problem, you cannot digest. You can feel, Maharaj, why they are doing, why this Rishi doing this way, why Vedabhyas doing this way, you can be in problem. So, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, you must go through Chaitanya Bhagavat. Even if you keep Chaitanya Charitamrita, at present you should not read Chaitanya Charitamrita, you should read Chaitanya Bhagavat. Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving suggestion. So, Bhagavat, what to speak about Bhagavat? But if you hear Bhagavat, from the lotus mouth of one pure Vaishnava who is himself Bhagavatam. Practice you can do. You can do in, if you are going to do practice, you can do. But through practice, if you are not going to hear Harikatha properly, you cannot make Siddhanta, you cannot understand any Siddhanta in Bhagavatam. So, in this way, you can be in great confusion. Like I told na, that somebody going to read so many books, after that they discover that Jiva Goswami Pad was totally against Rupa Goswami Pad and Sanatana Goswami Pad. This kind of Siddhanta can come in your life. So, whatever you are going to read, whatever you are going to, you should be under the guidance of pure Guru Vaishnava. Is, you know, you are going to get facility, otherwise big problem can be there. So, you see, Ashwatthama fall down and so many, you know, that name, Ajamil fall down, all they, so many cases there, fall down. Also, in Hari Bhajan, if somehow somebody is going to fall down after sannyas, then he has no right to go, suppose he has already in Varnasam system in India, he has no right to go back to his home and lead family life, and take the previous title. Because he already lived that title, he was initiated, after that he renounced order, after that he is going to enter into you know, already Achyuta Gatra. So after he fall down, if he like to go back to his, you know, family life again, Purvasram, and like to take the, again that Gotra and that, not possible. Now he is now out of Varnasam Dharma. He can do Hari Bhajan. There is no problem. He cannot do Hari Bhajan, that no. He can also attain perfection. But no more he can go back and take his old title, I think, nothing. His Gotra and title he cannot take. Not allowed. Now he is out of Varnasam Dharma. He can start Hari Bhajan, no problem. He can do Hari Bhajan. And through Hari Bhajan he can come out successful, that's not a big problem. So, Daiva Varnasam Dharma, Mahaprabhu also, I told that many times, Mahaprabhu never wanted to disturb common people. Mahaprabhu never wanted to disturb this system. So, I already told, when Sanatan Rup going to Purushottam Dham, they are staying with Sanatan Goswami, they are not going to fight that we can enter into Jagannath. They are going to express humble attitude. We have no right to enter into Jagannath temple. We are fallen soul. For whole life we are going to get, you know, Javan association. So this way humble attitude there, and they are going to stay with Haridas Thakur. Mahaprabhu also not going to put pressure on them. Why? You come Jagannath Mandir with us. No. Mahaprabhu not speaking. Haridas Thakur never wanted to enter into Gambira temple. Mahaprabhu himself, Jagannath Mahaprabhu himself going to give darshan to him. What he is lucky. So Mahaprabhu, when Haridas Thakur speaking that I cannot go inside Gambira temple because I am fallen soul, I am from Javan family, please don't, you know, please you speak to Prabhu. Then Prabhu not going to put pressure with them. Then you bring. I am speaking, please bring. Not speaking. This way you see, also that day you are speaking, the Hari Bhajan Aprakita Brahmanatta is 100% protected. You can do it if you like. Bhangshidas Babaji Maharaj, Gaur Kishadas Babaji Maharaj, or you go through their life, you can find. So, also, that day I was speaking, Kalidas, uncle of Raghunath Das Goswami, is doing bhajan very nicely. He believes in Uchishta, a Vaishnav. All the time he is collecting Uchishta from different Vaishnavs. This is bhajan siddhi. He is, you know, getting bhajan siddhi through Uchishta, seva. So one day he is reaching Jaru Thakur. He is from a very, very low caste. Jaru Thakur. Jaru Thakur, you know, you can grow through Gaur Parshad, you can find Jaru Thakur. So there actually Kalidas going with a bucket of mango, ripe mango, and going to meet him, pay dandavat, and they are two sitting in courtyard and speaking Harikatha. He is hearing, and Jaru Thakur speaking with great respect. He is going to pay dandavat, exchange of love. It is called Sangha. It is called actual Sangha. So they are actually, when giving this mango, this basket, and speaking is ripe mango, you will have to offer. Then Jaru Thakur speaking, you are my guest, you are coming to me, it is my duty to cook for you, but I cannot cook because I am from a very low caste. So if you give permission, I am going to give all raw material, rice, chal, dal, everything to a very nice Brahman Vaishnava family. There they can cook for you. If you take prasadam, I become very happy. Then Kalida speaking, I already took prasadam, I am not hungry. I come here to take your darshan, to hear Harikatha. When Kalida is going away, speaking, you will have to offer mango right now. Then after that Kalida is going to take shelter in a very, safe place, so that nobody can watch where he is waiting. Then Jaru Thakur, after he gone, asking wife to get out some ripe mango and Jaru Thakur going to offer to Krishna mentally and started eating. And after eating, skin and, you know, shit going to throw in a pot. Because Kalidas knowing that if I am going to take Uchista, asking Uchista, he cannot give me, I am sure. So this way I will take Uchista from him. So after that, when they are going to take mango prasadam and going to throw skin and, you know, shit into a dustbin, then after they gone, then Kalidas coming and taking that, you know, a shit and, you know, skin and licking very nicely and shedding tears. So this way, Kalidas getting siddhi. What kind of siddhi? Topmost siddhi. How? But through Uchista of Vaishnava. This way, if you are at all interested, if you have a strong belief in Guru Vaishnava, like Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, Vaishnava Vishas Vidhi Hok Khani Khani, if you are at all faith, then you should not fight. You go on following what is written in Shastra. It is not prejudicial conception. It is not apartheid procedure. Nothing. It is not blind faith. Nothing. You will have to follow and get result. So you will have to strong believe. You will have to believe strong belief in Guru Vaishnava. This way, Kalidas going to get success. That Chaitanya Mahaprabhu never allow anybody to take water wash of leg. But he is allowing Kalidas because he believe in Uchista. Three times. It was the usual rule. When Mahaprabhu entering into Jagannath temple, then Govinda going to give water on his lotus feet, is going to wash, then after that is going to enter into temple. That time, it was the system. Then Kalidas waiting up that what Mapu washing leg and Kalidas taking one handful of water, second handful, third handful of water and drinking. Mapu not speaking anything. It is written in Chaitanya Charitamrita, not even bird and beasts, even they cannot take this water. Strictly prohibited. But Mapu going to allow him because he attains Siddhi, Krishna Prema, through by Chap Uchista. We are busy with fighting. Why so? So this kind of show all the time. Those who are going to do bhajan, you know, a elevated sadhu, they are actually going to guide us. If we don't have any belief, then we are going to fight with them. We cannot follow them. Then Goshti Bhajan become useless. Goshti bhajan is 100% successful if you are going to follow rules and regulations set by Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur. If you are 100% going to apply the rules and regulations, you know, only shown by Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada, then in Goshti bhajan you can get 100% success. 100% success I cannot say because there is some drawback can be there. Because bonded soul sometimes going to go for so false ego, they are not going to obey. So we can say we can come out successful. But actually, Goshti bhajan is dangerous when you are going to do bhajan, some elevated sadhu, very nice sadhu. What to speak about? According to Daiva Varnasam, I cannot say that he is Brahman. He is topmost. Krishna Prema is going to. He is going to speak Harikatha, giving darshan, everything. But now, if he is going to speak somebody, something, to somebody, if he is not going to obey, then total system can break down. So this way I can give you example. Somebody going to cook in a temple. He is a big karma. He has, you know, big karma. His heart is full of karma. He is going to cook inside temple. But Prabhupada never told that. Prabhupada speaking, though you have some defects, you will have to attend this Brahmanism at least, then you can get seva. To start seva, at least minimum quality you should attend, that is called Brahmanism. So, according to that, Prabhupada used to engage devotees in seva. You can cook, you can clean utensil, you can clean temple, you can worship. This way Prabhupada used to give order to different devotees, different way. Not same. But at present, this chasm judgment is not there. Anybody coming, you come. Take red cloth, take sannyas, everything, and enter into puja. There is nobody to worship. So this way, big problem. So now I am going to speak. If there is Goshti Bhajan, and in Goshti Bhajan, who is going to cook, he is full of kama, anartha, disease. Who is going to worship, he is full of kama, anartha. Who is going to speak Harikatha, he is full of pratishthasa, anartha. Then all contamination. In that case, in Goshti Bhajan, though this Maharaj is there, still everybody, each and every member of that mat, they will have to seva this, share that papa, aparad. If a cook man going to do aparad inside kitchen, either pujari going to make aparad inside temple, all different kind of aparad, you have to take share. Everybody. Suppose 20 people there, they will have to share that aparad, everybody. And this kind of, so this way, in Goshti Bhajan, we can get big success. If you are going to follow big, big Guru Vaishnava, those who are there in temple, like Bhakti Bhavad Puri Goswami, Madhav Goswami Maharaj, Siddhar Goswami Maharaj, if you are going to follow them, then you can come out successful. They are going to give us treatment. If there is all mismanagement, everything, then in Goshti Bhajan, you can lose your power. This big problem can be there. Who can protect whom? Who can protect whom? So, Guru Vaishnava going to give some kippah to you. You have no power to accept it. So you are going to find fault with, that Maharaj. Maharaj cannot adjust with anybody. Are adjust doesn't mean that Maharaj can come down from his high level to low level. Adjust doesn't mean that Maharaj can come down from high level to low level and he can start acting like Shudra. He can start acting like Shudra. Then he is very good. You can say. Then Maharaj is very liberal, Maharaj is very good. Not that. Maharaj cannot break his acharan. Maharaj can give you kippah. If you have your power, if you have your desire to get, you can get. Not that Maharaj cannot adjust. You will have to adjust with Maharaj. You will have to come up. This is called adjustment. Adjustment doesn't mean Maharaj can leave all his acharan, everything, and come down to Shudra level like you. No uchishta, nothing, no vichar, nothing. You know, uchishta hand, you can serve, everything you can do. First of all, you will have to get established in bhakti, in acharan. Etiquette is topmost thing. If there is no etiquette, no acharan, in what level you are, I am less interested. I am not interested. I am less interested about what level you are at present. Because you have your power, you can attain any level. That doesn't mean you are going to get actual level. So, it's big danger can be there. Those big, big sadhu, I know so many examples. One example I can speak in front of you, that in Goshti Bhajan, you will have to follow those elevated Guru Vaishnava, those who are doctor. Those who are doctor. I can give one example. Thakurda, there are so many, you know, so many bhakta, you know, they were Babaji. Trigunathito Babadas Babaji Maharaj. Trigunathito Das Babaji Maharaj. He was actually given white vest, Paramahansa vest by Prabhupada. Mathura Das Babaji Maharaj, I was there in Govardhan, Dhanghati. He was doing bhajan. Also, they are doing bhajan. So, actually in Gaudiya Math, I already told, they are actually reserve force. In Gaudiya Math, those who are white devotees, white and a cloth, they are actually reserve force. Reserve force, Prabhupada used to speak. So now, if they are big, big doctors, they are going to give treatment. If you have your power, if you have your mind, if you have your faith, you can go on, you know, taking his instruction, acharan, everything. Otherwise, big problem. I can give one example, Thakurda. He used to stay with Srila Bhaktivedanta Madhav Goswami Maharaj. Thakurda, his name. He was a Babaji Maharaj. He was very nice Babaji. From, you know, by took base from Prabhupada, you see. Actually, those, you know, bonded souls, those who are staying in temple, they are not going to follow him, his etiquette. So, one day, kirtan going on, Babaji Maharaj going to do main kirtan in arati, 3 times. It was a main seva. Main seva. He used to do kirtan. And in the evening kirtan, some new kamar, new devotee, he started playing kartal, you know, wrong way. Babaji Maharaj playing, you know, some mridanga or something. I is going to, or, you know, kasar ganta, bell. And Babaji Maharaj giving indication, please try to maintain rhythm. Babaji Maharaj singing and playing, you know, ganta, bell, and he is going to play kartal in wrong way. 2 days, 3 days, 4 days, Babaji Maharaj repeatedly speaking, you should not play kartal, because you don't know how to play kartal. He is going to make, you know, some disturbance. He is not going to obey. One day, Babaji Maharaj doing full kirtan with full Baba, and he is making disturbance. Then Babaji Maharaj is going to throw this danda on him. And he heard, after that, arati is over. After that, arati is over. Then Pujari going to give some prasadam to Babaji Maharaj. Babaji Maharaj keeping this prasadam and calling this devotee, whom Babaji Maharaj strike with danda. Then after that, Babaji Maharaj, you know, he is coming inside room, is going to show love for him. I repeatedly speaking you for 3-5 days, 3-4 days. You should not play kartal this way. You are going to make disturbance in my kirtan seva. Because kirtan is not ordinary kirtan. It is one special seva, Babaji Maharaj. So you should maintain some rhythm. If you cannot, then you leave. Why you are going to show, today I was bound to, you are making disturbance. I was going to beat you. Please, you know, never mind. You take this prasadam and kiss him. This way actually, Babaji Maharaj wanted to teach him, if at all going to accept, then he, Goshti Bhajan is very successful. Then after then, another example I can speak. One Babaji Maharaj is there in Mayapur, his name I forget. And he took a white vest from Prabhupada or not, I forget. Then one day, Madhav Goswami Maharaj was not there. Some brahmachari going to pass in a very bad remark about Maharaj, speaking, very bad remark. Only sitting and eating, doing nothing, no seva, so all rubbish is speaking. Speaking, because he have no realization, he don't know, understand what is the stage of Babaji Maharaj, what is. Then one day he was, that brahmachari speaking so rough, that Babaji Maharaj was, you know, bound to go inside room and lock the room. For 2-3 days, Babaji was not opening door, not taking prasadam, water, nothing. Then when Bhaktivedanta Madhav Goswami Maharaj coming, first after entering, some brahmachari informed Guru Maharaj, Maharaj, Babaji Maharaj, they are not taking prasadam and water for 3 days in the inside room. Why? What happens? But that brahmachari speaking all rubbish against him, he actually to save him because he entered into room. Then with luggage, Bhaktivedanta Madhav Goswami Maharaj going, you know, that get sight and started crying. Madhav Goswami Maharaj crying and speaking, Babaji Maharaj, you are my godbrother, please open, please open. My disciple, all, you know, my santan, my all disciple, also your santan, your son, you should excuse. Please, please excuse, please open. Otherwise, also I am not going to take prasadam and water. I am coming from outside just now. Then Babaji Maharaj was bound to open door with tears rolling down his cheeks and embrace each other. Then the case is finished. This way, Bhaktivedanta Madhav Goswami Maharaj used to give treatment. Based somebody, if there is no treatment, no medicine, then how, what we can do with one mat and mission, what we can do? If there is no treatment, no arrangement, so Prabhupada wanted to at least, Prabhupada wanted to help us to attain at least Brahmanism, first. So otherwise all Sudra people, what they can do? Maybe they are coming now, at present they, if they are through Anugatha, they can do bhajan and go up and up and up. So those elevated devotees, those who are going to do bhajan, Acharya, you know, they are going to maintain their sabhajan. They are always going to maintain their sabhajan. That day I was discussing one point that I can discuss tomorrow, maybe next day. I can say, if I am going to show honor to somebody, and that my showing honor to somebody can help me in my Haribhajan, then what wrong in it? Sometimes Prabhupada used to say, Parasabhava karmani na prasansat na garhet. Sometimes speaking this way. And sometimes speaking, if I am going to give honor to somebody, if that honor, my giving honor to him, going to give some extra facility in my bhajan, then what wrong in it? So what is the demarcation? How you can understand? Parasabhava karmani na prasansat na garhet. This is one. Sometimes Prabhupada speaking, sometimes speaking, I can discuss next day to show. So sabhajan mean those who are doing actual bhajan, they have some principle, secret bhajan procedure. Anyway, they are not going to break that system. Krishnadas Babaji Maharaj, he used to do kirtan in parikrama party, everything, but Babaji Maharaj never going to break his own system of bhajan. When not going to get any time in the daytime, night time Babaji Maharaj doing Harinam. Whole rasta with midanga, playing midanga and doing kirtan. No tiredness, nothing. So they anyway, they are not going to break their savajan. They have some secret bhajan. They are not going to break the system. But at the same time, they are ready to help you. If you are interested to take that help, then okay. If you are not interested, then you cannot take. So, what is the procedure to maintain sabhajan? I can discuss next day. What is the procedure? How you can maintain your sabhajan? At the same time, you are not going to disturb the system. So, suppose some devotee is there in this stage. Prabhupada speaking, na? Gaudiya Hospital, number one bed, this patient is this kind of disease. Number two bed, this patient having this kind of disease. Number three bed, this patient this disease. So, Prabhupada wanted to mean that according to their disease, we will have to give treatment. According to their disease, if Acharya, if great Vaishnava not going to give treatment to us, then we are going to break down. We cannot do bhajan. Be careful all the time. Continuously, our Anugatha can help us. And they are also interested to give kippa. They are also, so that day I was speaking, what at present the stage you will have to watch, that this devotee is now in this stage. You cannot break his, sadharma, I mean duty at present. What kind of seva he is doing, you cannot break this system. So, na buddhi vedam janed ajnanam karma sanginam. So in family life, those who have some attachment, immediately you have no right to break his, system and speak. You come to Math and start bhajan, take sannyas. Then this can make great problem in his life. He cannot come out successful. At the same time, negative result can happen. So, na buddhi vedam janayed ajnanam karma sanginam. Jo shayat sarva karmani vidyan yuktaha samacharana. Actually, Krishna speaking, actually I have no duty, but still I am doing. Janak Maharaj is so elevated. Big Acharya, big Rishi Muni, they are going to take advice from Janak Maharaj. Still Janak Maharaj going to follow rules. Because if Janak Maharaj not doing, Janak Maharaj going to engage them in seva, proper seva. So it is the duty of an acharya to do seva himself, and so, you know, devotees, this way will have to do, this way will have to do, this way have to do. This way it is a system. So, to maintain. So next day I can show you what do you mean by savajan. What is the tactics of Radharani? I can show you next day. This way all elevated devotees, anyway, they are not going to break their own system of bhajan. They are doing their bhajan, at the same time they are giving enough time for you all so that you can understand Siddhanta, you can get association, you can get enjoy their love and affection, you can feel inspiration to do bhajan. This way, please don't try to, fight. You know, this is not good. So I can give so many examples so that I can show what is the mood of Prabhupada, how Prabhupada wanted to implement the Daiva Varnasram. Not that I am actually with Tilak Mala. I am Brahman. I am already, I have taken. You see, I have started. I started doing all rubbish. This is not the system. Prabhupada never wanted to speak this way. Now system totally disturbed. What to do? So this way, actually, we can try to understand next day that Sabhajan, how elevated devotees, they can help us to do bhajan. At the same time, they can go on doing their own bhajan to help us. So, up to this point, I like to stop. If any question there, you can put. I am ready to give you answer. So, this meaning I can speak someday. I am going to discuss so many things about Prabhupada and his teachings, because it's confusing. Ordinary people, they cannot understand. So, Nikhilo bhubano maya chinna bichinna karti bibudo bahulo megyam mukti mahanta datri sithilito vidiraga raddhara deshadani bilasatu hidnityam bhakti siddhanta bani vancha kalpatur vasike basindi bhavajo patitanam pavanu bhavishna bhyo namo namo.